sharing 30 koi fish varieties with you. That is what this video is all about. Let's get started quickly with the first variety. Kohaku have a solid white base with red markings on it. These red markings we call the heat plates or hibon. The brighter the white and the deeper the red color is, together with a shiny skin, is considered as a good quality skin on a kohaku. There are various varieties of the kohaku. For example, Deutsche kohaku, which is scaleless, a Kindering kohaku with shiny scales, a Tansho kohaku with a red round marking only on the head, and many more names for diverse patterns. Together with the kohaku, this is also one of the most classic koi. It also has a white base with red markings just like the kohaku, but now also black small spots are introduced. For a good quality sanke, it is important that the sanke has a very nice kohaku pattern, with bright colors and a little bit of shiny skin. On top of that great kohaku pattern, the sanke should have nicely placed small black dots. A Japanese judge will like it when some of the black spots, the sumi spots, are placed on some important places. Like for example on the shoulder section, which we call the katazumi. Same as with kohaku, we also have different types of sanke. We have the normal scaled sanke, but also the Deutsche sanke, which basically has no scales. There is also Tansho sanke, meaning it is entirely white with a red round marking on the head. And Ginrin sanke, a sanke with shiny elements in each scale. The Showa is also one of the more traditional koi varieties and also a very popular one as well. A Showa is sometimes misinterpreted as a sanke, and this also happens the other way around, but it are actually totally different koi. A Showa has a black base and is born as an entirely black fish in the first days. And on that black base, a Showa has white and red markings. So black is the base color instead of white, as was the case with the sanke. It is important that a Showa has black markings on the head area, but actually all three colors should be visible there, so also white and red should be visible on the head. Over the rest of the body, the colors should be nicely balanced. There are multiple varieties of Showa. For example, we have Deutsche Showa, which is a scaleless koi. We have Kindrin Showa with shiny elements over the entire body. We have a Tansho Showa with a red round marking on the head and white and black on the rest of the body, and many more variations. The Tansho. Tansho refers to the round red marking on the head area, but the Tansho itself actually is not a real variety, so the Tansho itself does not exist. It is always a class or part of another variety. For example, we have Tansho Kohaku, which is a completely white koi with a red round marking on the head. We also have Tansho sanke, which is a sanke with only a red marking on the head area. And we have Tansho Showa, which is a red marking on the head, which is actually a Showa. But also other varieties can be Tansho. For example, the Tansho Kujaku, which is a Kujaku with a red round marking on the head. Now, since you have just seen a Tansho Kujaku, we will continue with the Kujaku variety. Kujaku have a white base with orange markings on it. And on their scales, they have a kind of darker grey to black marking visible, which makes the Kujaku look like as if it has a net pattern on the back of the koi visible. This makes it a more special variety. Sometimes on a Kujaku, the orange pattern can almost become dark red. This is also referred to as a red kujaku. The Shiro Utsuri is an entirely black koi with white markings on it. When a Shiro Utsuri is born, it is actually completely black in the first days. The white will start to appear later on. This actually is reversed when the Shiro Utsuri becomes older. You will see that now the Shiro Utsuri is usually bright white, and the black will slowly become deeper and come up. A high quality Shiro Utsuri has very bright white visible with dark shiny black visible on top of it. The reason why the white should be as wide as possible is so that the contrast of black and white becomes larger. This makes the Shiro-Itsuri look way better. Also for Shiro-Itsuri there are different varieties. We have for example Deutsche Shiro-Itsuri, which has no scales, and Ginden Shiro-Itsuri, where every scale has a shiny element in it. The Hiyutsuri is a koi with a black base with red markings on it. He actually stands for red. When the Hiyutsuri is born, it is entirely black in the first few days. The red will slowly come up and cover a large part of the Hiyutsuri's body. It does not always look deep red, but it can also be dark orange. Over time it will usually become darker and darker, so the red becomes more dark. It is desirable that the red is as bright as possible. Also for Hiyutsuri there are different variations. For example Ginden Hiyutsuri, which have in each scale a shiny element visible. A Kiyutsuri is similar to a Hiyutsuri. Ki stands for yellow, so a Kiyutsuri is a koi with a black base with yellow markings on it. Usually it is more difficult to find a very nice and clean Kiyutsuri, as oftenly small black spots tend to be visible in the yellow parts, which makes them look a little bit less nice if you ask me. Known breeders for Kiyutsuri is the Maruhiro Koi Farm and also Ofuchi or Otsuka. Next to Kiyutsuri there is also Ginden Kiyutsuri, which has shiny scales. Asagi are very nice koi, they have a very nice net pattern visible of blue scales on their back. On the lower parts of their body they have orange visible, which is also visible in their tails, fins and gill plates. The nicer the net pattern of an Asagi is, the more lovely it will be. A very good breeder for good Asagi is the Kataoka Koi Farm. For a good Asagi, it is important that the red is only visible below the lateral line, and surely not above it. Also no red should be visible on their head area. Next to Asagi there is also Hi-Asagi, where red covers the entire body. And there is also Ginden Asagi, with shiny scales, which can surely look very special. It is nice to bring up the Shishui as next variety. This is a Deutsche version of the Asagi. Deutsche stands for scaleless. Shishui have a row of dark blue colored scales visible on the middle of their back, which looks like a zipper. Same as for the Asagi, also here again the dark orange or red should only be visible on the gills, fins and on the bottom of their body. For Shishui, it is okay when the red comes a little bit higher above the lateral line, but the top area of the Shishui should not be covered with red. There is also the Hi Shishui, where red actually covers the entire body of the fish. Next up is the Ginmatsuba. Ginmatsuba is a white koi that doesn't have any markings, but it surely is a great koi to watch because of its nice pinecone pattern on its back. You can also clearly spot there is a shine and luster visible which covers the entire body. This is the metallic part of the koi. The white on a Ginmatsuba should be as white as possible without any black markings visible. On the head you will often see some darker areas just above the nose, which looks like eyebrows. This is typical for the Ginmatsuba variety. Next to the Ginmatsuba there is also the Akamatsuba, which has a red base, and Aka also means red. And there is also the Kimatsuba, which has a yellow base, and Ki stands for yellow. Yamabuki Ogon is a bright yellow metallic koi. When translated, Yamabuki means yellow chrysanthemum flower. Compare the yellow color of the Yamabuki Ogon with a yellow chrysant. There are quite some similarities visible. Just like the flower, the scales also have deeper and lighter yellow areas visible. Over the lifetime of a Yamabuki Ogon, most oftenly the yellow becomes deeper of color. Sometimes it can reach even orange color, which is not so preferred. It should be as bright yellow as possible. Typical for Ogon varieties is that they have very nice Fukurin visible. Fukurin can be spotted when watching the scales. Around each scale is a wrap of skin visible. This gives a nice kind of pattern or texture. Orangey Ogon is a solid metallic orange koi. Of course this variety is orange, hence the name orangey. This may also look a little bit red as well, but lighter as for example the variety Benigoy. Orangey Eugen is not a real common variety. You do not see Orangey Eugen very often in stores, usually only as young koi in their first year, sold as 10 to 15 cm koi at koi shops and dealers. What can also be spotted clearly on this variety is the Fukurin. That is the case for every Eugen variety. You can now see the scaled version of the Orangey Eugen. There is also a Deutsche version, which has no scales. Mizuo Eugen is surely not the most common variety. Probably it won't also be the first koi that you will get for your own pond. It is also a very nice variety. Look at the nice zipper of dark blue scales it has visible on its back. Mizuo Eugen is a Deutsche variety, that means it has no scales. It only has scales on the back, which are colored dark. The rest of the body is entirely red and dark orange. When Mizuo Eugen are young, the orange can still be lighter colored, but over time the orange will become darker and darker. To continue with Eugen varieties, there is also the Mukashi Eugen. Mukashi actually means old when you translate it from Japanese. It has a kind of grey type of skin, but it can look up to bronze with a metallic shine visible. I'm now showing a Deutsche Mukashi Eugen to you, which means it is actually scaleless. There is also the scaled variety, or the Wagoi Mukashi Eugen. On that variety you will see that each scale is a little bit darker and around the scale the color tends to be lighter. It gives a very nice effect. Mukashi Eugen is a variety that also tends to grow really quickly. That were the first 15 koi varieties I wanted to share with you. In part 2 we will continue with another set of 15 koi varieties and all the details about them. Make sure you subscribe and I will see you again in the next video.